What?
That animal. There's something out there, Donnie.
Baby, come on. It's nothing. It's probably just like a wolf or a bear or something. Oh, don't worry. Look, we're in a car. No one's gonna bother us.
Are you sure?
Yeah, baby.
Well.
Baby, come on. It's okay, really. Huh? Almost finished what we started. Yeah?
I know you heard that. I know you did.
Yeah. Yeah, I did.
Then go out there and check things out, or we're not finishing anything.
Okay. About losing your head over a girl.
That was the kind of sick thing to say, man.
What?
Just kidding around.
So what the hell happened here, Roberta?
Well, good morning to you too, Joe.
Sorry, I haven't had my coffee yet. What's going on?
So far, best we can tell, we got two bodies here.
The best we can tell?
We got a lot of pieces here, Sheriff.
It looks like the Ulrich kid's car.
Yeah. We confirmed that with the IDs we got out of the wallet. Donnie Ulrich and Sandy Sanders. Just a couple teenagers out for a little hanky-panky.
Well, let's keep that out of the report, okay? It's bad enough I gotta tell the parents their kids are dead.
Yeah.
All right. Of course. Let's check that out.
Okay.
All right, open it. That's enough. Close it. What the hell could have done that?
I don't know. Coroner said it must have been some kind of animal. What I've seen, I have to agree.
Yeah, but what kind of animal does that to their prey and then doesn't eat it?
Only one kind I can think of. The human kind.
Bingo.
So what? You think we got some kind of serial killer wacko on our hands?
I don't know what I think right now, Roberta. I really don't. I'm just kind of thinking out loud. Let the coroner report tell us. But in the meantime, we should shut down the parks and the campgrounds just to be safe.
Okay, you got it, Sheriff. So, you still on for dinner tonight?
Was that tonight? Hey, I was just kidding. Yeah, we're on for dinner today.
I don't know what I'm going to do with you, Joe. I really don't.
Yeah, I got two ex-wives saying the same thing.
Mm. On that note, I think I'll get back to work.
Good idea.
Yeah.
What can I do for you, Sheriff? I want pictures of that. Good ones. From every angle. Then I want you to email them to zoos, museums, and universities. And anywhere else you can think of. Until we can find somebody who can hopefully identify what did that.
You got it, Sheriff.
Right. And send some to my office, too.
Will do. Anything else?
Yeah. Tell me what happened here.
Well,
never mind. Just get the pictures taken care of.
Yes, sir.
We just wait for them to finish up. Then go down there and pick up the trail.
That could take hours, boss.
I'm sure it will. And I don't care.
Why don't we just cap the whole mess of them and go about our business?
Because that would make a mess. And I don't like messes. Besides, if it did something stupid like that, I would have 1,000 state troopers out here looking for us. Is that what you want?
Guess not. No.
That's why I don't pay you to think. So don't. That sheriff gets in my way, he'll get his. Not right now. Let him do his job. He might just take us right to our prey. You got it?
Yes, sir.
You got it?
Yes, sir, I got it.
Okay, everybody, gather around. Okay. Originally, we had 3 couples in the group, but the last one's backed out. Does anyone have a problem with that? Okay. These are the Chadworths, Edward and Linda. And these are the Parkers, Charles and Cindy. As you know, we're going out into the wild for a period of 3 days with very limited supplies. The idea being to create a survival situation that forces us to survive off the land using our own skills and nothing else. But don't worry, because I always bring this. It's an emergency GPS beacon. I push this button, and help will get to us in 12 hours or less.
So, that thing pretty much works from anywhere?
Pretty much, yes.
Pretty much? What do you mean exactly, pretty much?
Don't worry, Mr. Chadworth. It'll work from anywhere we're going.
I see, and I'm fine with it. I just wanted to make sure it worked, that's all.
Okay, folks, let's get moving.
What do you think he's afraid of? It's only going to be a few days.
Maybe he's afraid of the woods. He's not afraid. He's never been camping before.
Never been camping before? Hey, Eddie, where the hell did you grow up?
I grew up in New York. You got a problem with that?
No, I got no problem with that at all. But I will kick your ass if you don't get out of my face.
Really?
Really?
Don't do it, Charlie.
Shut up, Cindy. You want to dance? Come on, let's do this.
I gotta take care of my problems with my brain and my fist.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well, how about you think this over right after I break your nose? Come on!
What the hell do you two think you're doing? The first rule of survival is to count on others in your party, not to kill each other. You two are standing here ready to fight each other, and we haven't even started yet. Are you crazy or just stupid? Which one is it? Now, come on. Suck it up, both of you. Shake hands, and let's get this show on the road. You heard her, Ed. You heard her, too.
Okay, all right. Sorry, Ed. I just get a little pissed off real fast.
Me too.
Okay. Can we finally get started on our trip now?
By all means.
Okay.
Do this thing.
First thing a person needs to do when they find themselves in a survival type of situation is to get their bearings. Figure out about where they are, and decide whether they're going to stay still and wait for rescue, or choose a direction to go for and facilitate self-rescue. That's where we're headed, to that point up there.
That's far.
It's only a few miles away, and right now we've got just enough time to make it there and build ourselves a shelter for the night, so let's keep going.
That's really far.
Well,
Yes. Okay. Are you absolutely sure about this? Okay. Thank you very much. I owe you one.
Professor, you've had calls.
Forget about the calls, Thomas. We have a live case. Let's go.
And where are we going?
Road trip.
Cool. Where to this time?
It's a small town called Morningside. It's a couple hours drive north. They just had an attack last night.
An attack? Oh, that's odd, isn't it?
Yeah, it's different, but it's happened before. But this will be the first time we get to be there just after it happened.
Cool.
This is going to be huge for us, Thomas.
Cool.
Is the van ready?
Yeah, ready. Gassed up, ready to go, just like always.
Good, you drive. I gotta change clothes.
Cool.
I'm telling you, Sheriff, it's real bad timing for something like this to happen in our town. It's summertime, Joe. We have the pumpkin festival coming up and other things, and the last thing we need is this kind of publicity.
I know that cost him an outrage, but I can't change the timing of these things. These things happen when they happen. You know that.
I know, Sheriff. But you could possibly avoid a disaster for us by keeping it quiet and getting it solved as quickly as possible.
I've got a bunch of body parts down in the morgue that used to be two teenagers. This ain't gonna solve itself.
All I'm asking you to do is whatever you can to expedite things. We normally get over 100,000 visitors to this township during the festival, Sheriff. We rely on that income. The township needs it to survive.
I know that. I've lived here over 25 years. Look, why don't you just leave me alone and let me do my job? I'll do my very best to get this over as soon as possible.
That's all I'm asking, Sheriff. And please, try to keep the press out of this.
I'll do my best.
Thank you, Sheriff. And good day to you.
You too. Asshole.
Excuse me. Sheriff Kelly?
Yes, that's me.
Hi, I'm Professor Sarah Evans from the National Museum of Anthropology.
How do you do? And how in the world did you get wind of this so fast?
We have our ways, Sheriff.
I'm sure you do. But I don't have time for this right now. I'm very busy.
Well, my office has the full backing of the President's Scientific Board for the discovery of new species, and I'm afraid you're going to have to make time for this, Sheriff.
Okay, what is it you want?
I want to see everything that you have on last night's attack.
And that makes two of us.
Come again?
I haven't seen everything we've got yet. You're welcome to tag along, if you'd like to. But I'm warning you, you get in my way one time, you're out of here. I don't care who's backing you up. Can I make myself perfectly clear?
Yes, perfectly. And may I say I don't want to hinder your investigation whatsoever, and I don't want you to think of me that way, Sheriff.
Wonderful. I'll do my best. Come on.
Sheriff, man, the phone has been hopping. Everyone and his brother's been calling to find out what happened last night.
And what have you been telling him? No comment, and don't tell him anything else, okay? You got it?
Right.
All right, just relax and take care of it.
Sorry, Sheriff. Hey, Sheriff. We've got Donnie R., Eric's father, on the phone. He wants to know that we need him to come in and identify the body.
Are you kidding? No way. Listen, tell him that I'll come and talk to him as soon as I can. And just be kind with him, okay?
You got it, sir.
All right. Take care of it. Can I get you a cup of coffee, a soda pop, or something?
No, Sheriff, I'm fine. Thanks.
Why don't you sit down and tell me again why you're here.
I'm here to find out what happened to those two kids last night.
What are you going to do when you find out that a person did it? I mean, it's still in my jurisdiction.
Well, you see, Sheriff, that's where we differ. I don't think a person did this.
Sheriff, the coroner's ready for you down the hall. Who's this?
Hi, Professor Sarah Evans from the National Museum of Anthropology.
Deputy Roberta Glickman, Morningside Sheriff's Department.
Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure's mine. Sheriff?
Yes.
The coroner's ready for you.
Thank you, Deputy. I suppose you want to go with me? I hope you can handle this. It's not going to be pretty.
Don't worry about it, Sheriff. You'll be just fine.
I hope so. Some company with you today. How delightful. That's delightful, yeah.
I'm Professor Sarah Evans. How do you do?
Ooh, a professor with some soft hands. I like that very much.
I don't
knock it off, Doc. Listen, I don't have time to waste. Show me what you got.
Oh, yes, okay, of course. Here we have Sandra Sanders.
Oh, my God.
What could have done that, Doc?
Oh, I really have no idea, Sheriff. No idea.
You don't know what did it?
Well, no. I'm just a coroner, not a magician. Magician.
Could a man have done it?
Yes, I mean, I suppose so. You know, maybe if he was on PCP, you know, or if he had some sort of a gardening tool as a weapon, you know, tool as a weapon.
Is that the old rich boy over there?
Well, yes, that's him, all right. Come. Come. At least, well, what's left of him? Not much, I'd say. Not much.
No man did this.
Oh, very observant, Professor. Yes, brains and beauty. That's a dangerous combination. But you are right, Professor. No man did this. No. In fact, no man could do this because no man is strong enough to do this. Well, wait. Here, see. His feet were literally torn off of his legs. And his head? His head was torn off as well.
So no man could have done this?
No chance.
What about an animal, Doc?
Oh, yeah, I mean, I perhaps so, I think. I mean, there are animals that, right, are strong enough to do this. Bears, for instance. But, you know, in almost all documented reports of bear attacks on humans include them eating their prey, or at least, you know, some portion of it. And well, it would appear to me that whatever did this was not interested in, you know, just only a carnage.
Well, Deputy Roberta found some long brown animal hairs at the crime scene. It must be some kind of animal.
Were they long, very thick, coarse hairs with a foul odor to them?
Yes, exactly. How would you know that?
Ooh, it seems our lovely professor knows more about this than me. Think so.
If you have something to tell us, there's no time like the present.
Sasquatch.
Ooh, Sasquatch.
What? Sasquatch, Yeti, abominable snowman, Bigfoot, whatever you want to call it. That's what did this.
That's not real. Come on, that's something that they used to scare kids around a campfire. Right, Doc?
It could be real. I mean, we haven't proven it yet, but we're very close. I mean, there's been a lot of cases, a lot like this, very recently.
With this kind of mutilation?
Yes.
Excuse me. You know what? Come with me. I think
what
I
is it, Doc?
You have something else that you should see. Something else. See? In fact, I only thought of it because our lovely professor mentioned Bigfoot. Yeah, here we go. Bigfoot. Huh.
That was taken from the crime scene?
Yes, that's what I was told. Yes.
How big is it, Doc?
Oh, it's just over 18 inches. Just over.
That would make the creature about 10 to 13 feet tall.
What?
That's precisely right, Press. That's precisely right. Ooh, yes.
You mean we have a 10-foot tall killer Bigfoot on the loose out there?
It would appear that way, yes.
Oh, great. Yes, great.
Take a good look around and tell me what you see.
Let me guess, more trees.
That's okay. Edward and Linda, what do you see?
A valley.
That's right. And what do most valleys have running through them?
Rivers.
That's right. And what do most rivers lead to?
Town, people.
Give that man the golden ray. That's exactly right, Edward. Very good. So that's our path down to the valley floor.
Good job, babe.
Thank you, babe. Not bad for city boy.
Daylight's wasting. We gotta get down there and set up camp for the night. So let's keep going, guys.
Look at this guy.
I'm telling you, Thomas, I think we're onto the real thing this time.
Really?
Yes, really. Those two kids were torn apart last night. They even have hair samples and footprint molds. A Bigfoot? Yes, I do. I really do.
So what you're saying is
Did I hear you mention Bigfoot?
What if I did?
There's a guy in the bar who knows all about him.
Is that a fact?
He sees him every day. His name is Cruda. Why don't you go in and ask him?
Well, thank you very much for that information.
You're welcome.
Do we have to go in there?
We have to.
Talking to me.
Yes, I'm Professor Sarah Evans, and this is my associate, Thomas Abelman. Do you mind if we sit down and talk to you for a moment?
This is free country, ain't it?
Yes, it is. Someone told us that we've seen a Bigfoot out here. Is that true?
I could use another beer.
Would you tell us what you know, please?
I need another beer.
This guy's wasting our time, Professor. He's just a drunk.
Yeah. That's right. I'm a drunk. Everybody in here knows it, too. I bet you I'm a drunk and knows what you want to know, boy.
Would you get him another beer, please?
All right.
Now will you tell us what we want to know?
About them Bigfoots?
Yes.
I see.
Them? You've seen more than one?
Damn right, woman. There's a whole mess of those things out there. What are you talking about?
Well, keep going, please. Bartender, can you get him another beer? Just keep him coming while we're sitting here.
Here you go, Cooter. Thank you, Jenny. First time I ever saw one, I was coon hunting. I turned around and there he was. Bigger than life. He's 10 foot tall if he was an inch. And he had these big, huge set of claws on him. He looked like they cut you right in half.
And what'd you do?
Well, I shot him. Damn right. That only pissed him off. I got out of there as fast as my legs would carry me. He got my dog, though. I think he ate him, too, because I ain't never seen poor old Cooter again since that day.
Your dog's name was Cooter?
Well, what else would it be?
Was that it with the Bigfoot?
No. weeks after that, I was chopping wood behind my trailer. Here come another one. Threw my axe at him, though. I tailed it back inside the house. That critter went crazy running around, pounding on everything, shaking the walls. Broke every window in the place. Hell, I barely made it out of there, fighting him off with an old baseball bat I had just to keep him getting in. Right then's when I figured out what he really wanted there.
And what was that?
Well, he wanted to kill me now, that's for sure. But that ain't the only reason he was there. See, the first thing he wanted to do was he wanted to... Hey, you tell me.
You were saying?
First thing he wanted to do was he wanted to have sex with me.
I don't think that's very funny.
But you're damn right it ain't funny. I hurt like hell.
You don't have any real evidence of your encounters, do you?
I got me a bunch of photographs that nobody's ever seen before.
Well, if you're telling the truth, I'd be interested in buying those. Providing they're good.
I want to drink beer here for free for a month. That's without paying now.
That could be arranged.
I tell you what then, little darling. Looks like maybe me and you got us a deal, okay?
Very good, guys. It's really good. This ought to keep you protected from the elements and even keep you dry if it rains.
It's really pretty simple to do.
Only because you two paid attention. What in the world are you two doing?
Go in the shelter like you told us to.
Problem is, that's not going to shelter you from anything. What are you going to do if it rains?
Rain, there's not a cloud in the sky.
Listen to her, Charlie.
Shut up.
The point, Mr. Parker, is to be prepared for the unexpected. Therein lies the key to survival in the wild. Tear this thing down. Start over, and this time make it rainproof. You mean I have to get my hands all dirty again? You do whatever it takes.
Let me tell you something. We get into a situation where we gotta start eating each other. She's going first.
Joey, stop it. That's disgusting. Enjoy the soup while you can. It's the last regular food you're gonna have for the next few days. Tomorrow, we're gonna set up snares for game and dig around for roots and other edibles.
What kind of game?
Rabbit, chipmunk, squirrel, pretty much anything we can catch. That's if we're lucky enough to catch anything.
I don't think I can eat any of those. They're all so cute.
You hungry enough, you'll eat them.
You know, look at me. You're the one who wanted to do this.
I know.
Oh, my God!
Where is she?
What in
the... Where's Sharon?
What the hell did we just see here?
Did you hear that?
Yeah, baby, we all heard that. That's it. I got enough of this shit.
Thank you.
might shoot one of them.
Fuck them.
Charlie!
Not now!
We have to help them!
Now, we're not going anywhere. And that thing, whatever it is, that wants to come get us, let it come. There it is. Come on. Come on! Don't shoot, it's me! Have you seen my wife?
No.
We gotta go back in there and find her. Yeah, I don't think that's gonna happen. Hey, man, don't say that. Look, we got a real problem here. And believe me when I tell you, you get in my way, I'll put you down.
Charlie, stop.
Shut up. And that goes for you, too. Stay out of my way. Man, you're a really big man with that gun in your hand, aren't you? That's right. You got a problem with that?
This way.
Where to, boss?
Get some bait.
Joe? We got a problem.
Yeah, no kidding.
No, I'm talking about a new problem. We just found out that Sharon Farmer took a party of four up to the mountains yesterday on one of her little survival trips.
That's not good. Any more good news?
Well, it's a bunch of guys gathering down at the county lot, talking about going out on their own and hunting this thing down.
Just what we need. A bunch of idiots running around the woods shooting at each other. I'll go talk to them. You gather the deputies together, and we'll go search for Sharon Farmer's party. I'll meet you back in the parking lot in 5.
Okay, you got it.
Hey, guys.
Now it's not hunting season, right? Something killed those two youngins out there last night, Sheriff, and we're fixing to do something about it. Ain't that right, boys?
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
So what do you think about that? Think your truck's illegally parked? Do what? This is a county lot, and you're illegally parked. It's like I'm going to have to tow you, Steve. But first, I want you to put your shotguns in the back of this truck. And I mean now!
It ain't going to be that easy, Sheriff.
Yes, it is. Watch this. Now, I'm going to tell you guys one more time. Put your guns in the back of this truck, or I'm going over to the courthouse, and I'm going to swear out a warrant for each and every one of you. Now, you all know me. You know I'll do it. Now, what's it gonna be? That's it. Put him back there. Don't worry, I'll get him back to you. That goes for you too, Steve. And give me your keys.
Damn, Sheriff. Why you gotta go spoil all our fun?
You come by in the morning, I'll get him back to you. No fine. Now, look, I want you guys to go out, get yourself a beer or whatever, and relax, okay? We got everything under control here.
You have everything under control, do you?
Yes, as well as can be under the circumstances, yes.
I see. Listen, I had a talk with Mr. Brown.
Cooter? Did you talk with Cooter Brown? That's precious.
I don't understand.
Well, he's a town drunk. Last year he told everybody that he was abducted by aliens and that they wanted to have sex with him.
And if it keeps the beers coming, he'll tell anybody anything. They want to hear anything.
Well, it just so happens that I'm going to get a lot more than just stories out of him.
Really? You mind walking with me? Got a lot going on right now.
Sure.
Williams, take care of the truck.
Got it.
So you're telling me that Cooter gave you actual photographs of a Bigfoot?
Nobody's agreed to sell them to me.
But you haven't seen them yet?
Not yet. I'm going to meet him in a couple months.
Save yourself some time and money and don't go. There are no pictures.
Well, he seems pretty convincing.
Listen, that's what he does. That's all he does. The man lives on disability. If he had the pictures, he'd have sold them already.
Okay, so you're right. That doesn't prove the creature doesn't exist.
No, it doesn't. But you're going to have to excuse me. I'm going to have to go do my job for a little while.
What's going on here?
We're going to go out and search for a party of five in the woods, just to be safe.
Can I go with you?
It's out of the question. No. This is official business.
Well, if you think for one second that what I'm doing is an official business, you are sadly mistaken. Do you understand how important this can be?
What I understand is I have two dead teenagers, and I don't want to see any more people get hurt.
Well, I'm going with you.
No!
One phone call, and I could have the military rolling in here in a matter of hours, and this entire investigation would be out of your hands.
You know, that's really too bad. I was just starting to like you.
Shall I?
Okay. Okay. You can come along, but don't get in the way.
Deal.
No deal. That's the way it is. Do we understand each other?
Perfectly.
Come on.
All right, deputies. Follow me on up to Twin Forks Road. We'll start our search from there.
Sheriff, you mean we're going after one of Cooter Brown's Bigfoots?
No, we're going to go look for Sharon Farmer's party. But you're staying here.
Huh?
Somebody has to watch the office. You're the one.
But, Sheriff, I...
No, don't argue with me. Take care of it.
Yes, sir.
So,
Roberta, you're going to have to ride with someone else today. I got to take the professor with me.
Okay. All right.
Getting in the middle of anything, am I?
No. There's no problem. We're all professionals here, right?
I suppose so.
Or lose the top of your head.
Let me shoot him, boss.
Shut up, number two.
But you promised I got to shoot somebody.
Shut up!
What's going on, Charlie?
Relax, honey. We're here to help you.
That's great.
Get up, both of you.
Hey, what's going on? Why do you have a gun pointed at him?
Shut up, Sonny. What a prince. Move it. Both of you, let's go.
Talking about.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Having a nice afternoon, Jimmy?
Yes, Sheriff. Doing just fine.
Good to hear it. Good to hear it. Just out for a drive this afternoon?
Yeah, you know, just a little drive. Killing time.
Yeah, I hear you. All right, you two, listen up. I know you like to have a beer party out here in the woods now and then. Frankly, I don't care. I really don't. But you're not having it tonight. You understand me? Not tonight.
Yes, Sheriff. Sure thing.
Don't play me, Jimmy. There's something going on here, and I can't talk about it right now. But it's not safe for either one of you to be out here alone in the woods tonight.
Sheriff, I don't think that...
Let me finish! Now look, I'm going to cut you a break on that beer that you got in the back there. The both of you better promise to me that you're going to town tonight, and you're going to stay there, and don't BS me.
We'll do what you say, Sheriff.
Yes, Sheriff. We'll do what you say. We promise.
Okay, then. You boys have a nice day.
You too.
Thanks, Sheriff. Thanks. Sheriff said.
Bobby?
Yeah?
I think we're gonna have ourselves a party.
Hell yeah!
Right on.
Hit it!
Farther till I get some answers. Keep walking. Or I'll show you what your insides look like.
Is that what you want? You want a piece of me? You big, ugly, deliverance-looking asshole?
You only last 10 seconds with me.
It's just what I thought. I've got a bunch of muscle heads with no balls.
You don't want to stop, do you?
Do me a favor. Cut it out. Act like you got a pair. Come on.
Hold it just a second. This won't take long. Now it's time to get your ass kicked.
Come on, buddy. It's okay. It's okay.
I crushed his windpipe. He's gonna die.
Not now.
You're dead.
Not now.
Why the hell not? You see what he just did.
And he'll get his. But not right now. Put the gun.
That was very impressive. Apparently you have some training.
Let's just say I learned from the best.
You try that on me, I'll rip your eyes out before your hand gets halfway to my throat. Turn around.
No.
Turn around.
Johnny! I tell you what, Jimmy, this is gonna be a great party, man.
Hell yeah.
I'm gonna get drunk, and I'm gonna get laid.
Hell yeah, you and me both, brother.
I got here as quick as I could, Professor. He really shouldn't be going with us.
He's not coming with us. He's coming with me.
Right, I don't have time to argue with him. We're losing daylight.
All right, everybody. We'll go in right here. I want you to separate by 20 feet from one another, left and right. We're going to start with a one-mile sweep and go in a straight line through the woods. You and your assistant go with me. All right, let's move out, and let's try and find them before dark. Come on, you guys. Let's get this done. Thank you.
tough guy. We're not gonna kill you.
No!
We're just gonna use you for bait.
There's that thing out there.
This is gonna kill you. You know what I'm talking about. You met up with it last night.
No, you can't do this. You can't.
Yes, I can and I will. I'm tired of the tree, too.
No, get up!
Get your hands off her, punk!
You wanna do this with one eye or two?
No, man, not yet. But I ain't far away, brother. I'm about to take her out in the woods and lay some pipe.
Lay that pipe, baby. Yeah, you the man. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey, Sheriff. What do you say, me and you take a little stroll through the woods? Are you giving me the silent treatment all of a sudden?
What is it, Jimmy?
Did you hear that?
It's probably Bobby finally getting him some.
Yeah, probably.
Speaking of getting him some.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
You go with Deputy Roberta, she'll take care of you. Take care of it. Be safe.
It's going to be okay now, sweetie. Don't worry, it's going to be okay. Williams, you come with me.
That was a slick little move you made there.
What do you mean?
A little throwdown you did on her.
Oh, that was nothing. I just learned that in a self-defense class.
Yeah, right.
We should split up. We could cover more ground.
May not be safe.
I'll be okay. Thomas, you come with me.
All right. We'll go out at 100 yards at an angle and in at 100 yards at an angle.
Diamond shape.
Exactly. And then we'll meet up at the top spot.
Sounds good. Let's go.
Let's go, guys.
Sometimes wish that were possible. Now point the gun away from me, please.
Sorry.
I'm gonna scout out the perimeter. Keep an eye on that clearing. You see that creature, kill it.
What about them?
Fuck them.
Got it, bud. told those boys to stay out of these woods last night. All right, man. We'll take a better look around, but be careful. Whoever did this may still be out here. Pay attention. All right, let's do it.
Hey, you! Whatever your name is, can you come out here, please? I just want to talk to you.
Shut up, Cindy.
No, I will not shut up, and don't tell me to shut up again. I hate when you do that. I really do. Won't you please think about letting me go? Just me? You can keep him. I'll do anything you ask. And I mean anything at all. I will, really. Anything you want. Just let me go before the thing comes back.
Anything?
Yes. Anything.
Okay. Get on your knees.
Don't even think about it, asshole.
Don't listen to him.
I'm not.
I'm not.
You're enjoying yourself a little too much there, don't you think?
What? Are you insane? I did exactly what you told me to do.
Goodbye, Cindy.
No. No, you're not leaving me here. Let me go. You're not.
It's a lot cheaper than a divorce.
You bastard.
That I am.
So, the man's killed my other man, too. You should have been working for me.
Get it over with.
Oh, no, not yet. I still don't have my base. But I think all that bleeding you're doing will bring it around. He's a bloodthirsty son of a bitch. It takes hours to die from a stomach wound. Very painful, too. So I've heard.
What about me? Will you not let me go? Please?
Don't even start me. I'm not as dumb as my late friend here.
Or do you feel like you can go on?
I could go on.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'll be okay.
Relax. Everything's fine now.
Everything's okay, all right? All right, man, let's move out. Put the knife down. Do you understand?
Yes.
Now, who are you, and what the hell is going on around here?
Cindy Parker, we were supposed to be on a 3-day survival tour.
The Sharon Farmer party?
Yes.
Where's the rest of them?
Gone. They're dead.
How?
There's a monster creature thing that killed a lot of them, and... my husband killed two of the hunters that were holding us captive.
Hunters? What hunters?
I don't know. There were three of them. That's one of them there. And another was killed a ways back.
And who's this?
My husband, Charlie.
He's been shot.
Yeah. By the third hunter. He's the really crazy one.
Where did he go?
There?
He's still alive.
I don't care. Not anymore.
I'm confused. Did a creature do this, or is it some raving maniac running around the woods killing people?
Both.
Both?
Yeah.
Right. Ben? I want you to find the closest place for the life flight chopper to land. I want you to get him to the hospital and take her with you. I'm going to put an end to this one way or the other.
You got it, Sheriff.
You be safe.
You got it, Sheriff.
All right.
Yeah.
You still going with me?
Absolutely.
Good. Let's go.
Matthews to dispatch, come in, dispatch.
Don't worry, everything is going to be okay now.
Yeah, that's right, about a mile or so due west of the county highway. 10-4 dispatch, over now.
Hey, they'll be here soon, let's go get that wounded guy.
No, you stay here and watch for the chopper.
I'll get him. You can get him.
Seeming more and more like this creature thing is a cover-up for some nutcase maniac running around the woods to kill people.
I could see why you would think that, but whatever took out Thomas was not a man.
What exactly did take out Thomas?
I don't really know. It happened so fast I could hardly see what happened. I mean, one second he was standing in front of me, and the next second he was gone. Just like that.
You didn't see anything?
It is a blur. dark-colored hair, a foul odor, and not much more. It happened very fast.
I'll tell you one damn thing. This is not a day I'll soon forget.
No, I am certain you will not.
Cabin. It's there for anybody that wants to use it. Let's take a closer look. Try and be as quiet as you can.
Found him. Yes. Lock in on these coordinates.
Don't be stupid. Don't kill a cop.
I've killed him before.
Sarah, get the gun.
Let him go.
Not a chance, bitch.
Oh, you just called me the wrong thing.
Nice shot.
Thanks.
Can I have the weapon? Thank you. All right, buddy. What's your story?
I kind of liked him.
Who the hell are you?
You are Hunter Crawford. Ex-Army Colonel, Special Forces Black Ops.
Yeah, who the hell are you?
The one who made more money than you were ever going to make killing a Bigfoot.
You're not a Bigfoot hunter.
I'm a manhunter.
What now?
We wait.
Buddy, we got a chopper coming, so just hang in there. Oh my God.
We've got them!
Oh no! No! He's gonna come for us now!
What is?
The monster!
Now just calm down. We're gonna be fine. There's no... The chopper's on its way.
No! We are not gonna be fine!
Yes, yes, we are. There is no monster.
Transfer it to you immediately.
I want to see it.
Sure.
Easiest money I ever made.
Mm-hmm. Very well deserved. I have a helicopter on the top of the hill to take you anywhere you want to go.
Thank you.
Thank you. I guess you're wondering who I am and what I want, yes?
You know I am.
You ran a special black ops operation in Nicaragua years ago, codenamed Red Viper. Do you recall that?
What, did you give me a history lesson?
I said, did you recall that, asshole? I wouldn't try my patience if I were you, Colonel. Remember a young captain on your team named Michael Danton?
No, I don't recall.
Well, you should. Because you killed him for disobeying an order to murder a mother and child.
So what? Who gives a damn about some stupid captain?
That captain was my son. And I've been looking for you a long time. And now that I found you, I'm going to straighten you out. Colonel Hunter Crawford, we're going to see how long and horrible and agonizing we can make your death. Fuck.
You'll be okay, all right? Let me get you home now. Okay?
Thank you. Wasn't sure what it was, but he ain't going back. Something told him this thing wants to eat.